Yo, what's good, YouTube? Let's just jump right into this. You know I like to make my videos short, sweet, and to the point. I want to talk about Black Ops 3 and what I saw from the E3 event, what I saw from other YouTubers like Drifter, like Ali A, like T Martin, Don't Judge. And I've even listened to some podcasts with my boy Jive Turkey, White Boy 7th Street, Wings of Redemption, and I believe Eddie the Chump. But I've been watching with very objective eyeballs. Very objective. Because what I see right now in this game, you may think you, and I mean you who don't play that much Call of Duty or haven't been a part of this franchise since MW2 or World at War, and you might just be new into the game and this is just all exciting for you. Right now, it's not exciting to me. What it is to me is something that I've seen before with a little bit of sprinkling of different things. Like the heads up display is a little bit longer and it's three dimensional. Well, that was in Advanced Warfare. If you put that perk on, then you can see the entire map. Okay, so really that's not different. Boost jumping. Oh no, that's not different. But their boost jumping is a little bit different because their boost jumping has a meter on it. So you can't just jump all over the place and you don't have the speed. So they've slowed down the pace of the game. Okay, that's not different. Wall traversing, running on the side of the wall and shooting. No, that's not different because I saw that in Titanfall. Oh, no. What about the guy with the like little spikes who jumps down on the ground and makes like a big wave and everybody dies around him? No, I've seen that before too, and that was in Destiny. That was a Titan. Yeah, a Titan. How about that insta-kill gun? Oh, no, I saw that before in Destiny 2, and that was a Hunter. Special abilities. Destiny. Wow. Wall traversing. Wow. Titanfall. Vertical maps, less linear but more vertical. I've seen that before too somewhere. Being in the water and being able to shoot while you're underwater. Where have I seen that before? There's so many different elements of this game that just take from other games. So you took 3 years of development to develop what? Your story, your campaign? Maybe because Advanced Warfare did at least come with a very good campaign, a very good script. So now you also brought back co-op play. You have up to 4 players in co-op. What are we seeing that is new? The definition of insanity is doing the same thing and expecting a different result. So Treyarch, what did you take 3 years to develop? You're still using the same engine. Now I'm not trying to be critical. What I'm trying to do is be objective. What have you seen in the game that is different? That they brought to the table that makes you want to buy this game as a consumer? What marketing, what sample size have they taken of people and feedback to develop this game? I mean, they brought back quickscoping. Who wanted quickscoping? How, what is the population? What is the sample size of people that they asked that wanted quickscoping back? Now, theater mode is back. Everyone wanted theater mode. Anybody who is a creator on YouTube, they wanted theater mode back because why? Because it gives them the ability to create and tell their story in a more cohesive and illustrative manner. That's why. But I will say this. This game will probably be better than Advanced Warfare. Why? Because they saw the shortcomings of that game. But I think Advanced Warfare did come with something different, something more robust. But it was just a little bit too much. So Treyarch's just going to take away the too much and give you just that nice, even kill. You know, the TTK in this game is super fast. A lot of people aren't going to like that. They don't like to get insta-killed. People don't like that. They want to be able to turn on you. You know what I'm saying? I turned on him! And now, here's the biggest thing that's a shock and a surprise. This is what's new. And I don't think Treyarch did it. Marketing, money, big corporation did it. PlayStation Now is the leader of the Call of Duty franchise because it gets the DLC first. That means that the game is more developed for the PlayStation rather than the Xbox. That's what I see. That, my friends, is the game changer. This has been your boy, Wayne the Average Gamer, and I'm out. Peace! 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 Peace!